can stop reggae.
Nobody can stop reggae. I kept waiting. But really, nobody can stop reggae. Now, there is a new religion in town. Mm-hmm. Justice Chacha Mwita of the High Court of Kenya ruled that Rastafarian is a religion like any other.
So this comes after a man had moved to court to challenge school's directive to send away his daughter because of having dreadlocks. Me watch and let me tell you, before we even get into the religion, this we need to address because there's a culture that we have where we can't wear our dreadlocks.
And it's your natural hair. You should be able to do anything you want with it. Another thing that's actually really, it's just so upsetting and it's so sad that it happens even here in Kenya where all our hairs are actually Afro kinky. Mm-hmm. And if you come to Jobo with your hair in an Afro, you're told like it's not professional. What is professional?
What are you supposed to do? But even this story has stirred up the pot of Muslims, especially in
Kenya. Muslims are upset.
Quite angry because they're saying they're not allowed to wear their scarves and hijabs.
Their hijabis.
Lakini, the Rastafarians, they can wear the dreadlocks.
Right, and also
so
Islam is also very much recognized religion. I actually agree with them and I understand where they're coming from.
It's thanks. But that's true.
We hope that's something that will actually come
be addressed. If you have a rule for all, it should be for all religions.
It should be for all. But I just feel that now probably the government should come in and actually put a proper legislation. Because you see, like in this case, fine, this has happened. But this isn't the first time that we've had a Rastafarian child being sent out. Also, in the same breath, we also have these cases of Muslim girls being chased out. In some cases, they're allowed to continue with the hijabis. In some cases, they're not. So which is it exactly? I think there should just be a general one for the whole country. So we don't have to keep taking...
For religion. It's either we're showing it or we're hiding it or all of us are allowed to show it.
But I really think, does it affect... Let me ask you, does it affect what you're doing? So menda shule kusoma. Me, I remember by then, in our high school, we weren't allowed to part our hair. Like, unashika nywele push back, that was it.
Even as our braids, you're not allowed.
What is that?
Am I thinking through my braids?
Mbona unafinyili mtu to that extent, you know?
But I think it's just that thing of schools having rules and regulations.